You mean to tell me that I actually get to play with Mr. Clean as a servant? What is up, guys? Today we're going to talk about the Buddhist Lancer of Shimosa, Hozoin Inshun. But before we get into all that, we have to dial it back and talk about his master, Hozoin Inne. So as a practitioner of the spear himself, Inne was the one who founded the Hozoin school. Here he taught Sojutsu, or the art of the spear. One night, Inne was standing outside Kofuku Temple, and he happened to notice the reflection of the crescent moon in a pond nearby. That same night, Inne was inspired to create the Jumonji Yari, a spear that was modeled after the crescent moon to strengthen its effective use. Originally, it was the Kama spear, and it only had one side, but he modified it after he received some advice. The logic behind the Jumonji, or the cross-shaped spear, was that since its design was out of the norm, you could thrust it in a spear fashion, hurl it like a halberd, or pull it like a sickle if necessary. Whatever the case may be, you will get hit to some extent. Now, there's no promise that your weapon wouldn't get stuck on your opponent, which in that case you'd be assed out with no weapon, but overall, it proved to be a choice piece of equipment. The moment that this spear hit the public, it changed the game, quickly spreading across his region and then making it worldwide. Through this spear's creation, Inne was able to open up his own school and foster many disciples. And one of these disciples was Inshun. Inne took Inshun into the school with open arms. However, by the time that he came into the school, Inne was already around 80 years old, far too old for him to pass down the arts of the spear himself. Instead, Inshun was able to learn the 15 forms of the Hozoin from Inne's closest disciples. The more Inne began to climb in age, he felt like it would be a shame if everything he had built up went to waste. He decided to pass the school on to Inshun, making him the second generation successor of the Hozoin line. But this was only under one condition. Over the years, Inne had changed his mind about how he viewed the spear. He told Inshun that people who are on the path to Buddha shouldn't be involved with the spear, and if you want to take over, you gotta give it up. Funny thing for you to decide after reaching 80 years old, but okay. Ultimately, Inshun, along with everyone else in the school, did as their master requested and dropped the spear. The moment that Inne finally kicked the bucket, Inshun immediately picked the spear right back up again, because a wise man once said, why not both? He continued to reign over the school, allowing everyone else to use their spears once more. Now, remember the days where monks were peaceful old men in robes that minded their own business? Yeah, not these guys. Inshun was known to be a Buddhist warrior monk. They emerged in the Heian period of Japan and were lethal in every way imaginable. This is also something that I cover in Oda Nobunaga's lore. It was a time where Buddhist warrior monks had teamed up with some of her enemies, and Nobu was aware of how much trouble these guys could actually be. So instead of fighting them up front, she just burned their temple to the ground. Ain't nobody got time for that. This is the type of fighter that you're dealing with when it comes to Inshun. A person would literally rather burn you alive than have to see you in that field. Another thing that we have to mention is that his role is probably the reason why he makes an appearance in Fate Grand Order. Legend has it that Musashi Miyamoto showed up to the Hozoin Temple in search of some lessons. She pulls up to the temple and is immediately confronted by a guy that's supposed to be one of their best men, Agon. Turns out that Agon, for a lack of better words, was a complete moron, and he just spent the entire first half of the match hyping himself up. Like, sir, what are you doing right now? So after he does all these things to intimidate Musashi and throw off her game, she just looks at him and says, "Are you done? Are you finished or are you done?" And then she kills him. Well, Inchun finds out and gives the classic, "You have dishonored my family." The two of them face off and she whooped his ass. Twice. Inchun was so impressed by her skills that he let her stay the night for some rest and relaxation, giving her some advice and a couple of things that she might need to know before she hit the road again. And that's about it. What? You thought I was gonna say something good about him? This is just another chance for me to suck off Musashi. You think I'm not gonna take it? All jokes aside, there's not that much information out there about Inchun. There's not that much information about his master, and Inchun is more of a minor character than he is, so go figure. Despite that, we were still able to get One Punch Man in grand order. I am not complaining. That about wraps it up. If you enjoyed the video, please drop a like so we can get this trending. Be sure to follow me on Twitter so you can get updates for the channel and when I drop my videos. Swing by the Patreon if you want to support the channel. And I will be back with more Type Moon content. It's your boy Saya. I'm out.